Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for an Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. Happy Monday, Mosh Pit. It's great to have you here for a brand new week of Isaac on the channel. Yesterday's video, almost at 5,000 likes. Really good turnout for a Sunday, especially. Thank you all, Mosh Pit. Everyone's super excited about making the next like streak goal happen. If it does cross 60 by this video, then we will be doing the live Q&A session on Saturday. That's going to be Saturday, and if that happens, keep an eye out on the community feed. That is the only place I will be posting a submission form where you can ask your AMA questions, and I will read them and answer them live on stream on Saturday. So thank you all very much. I hope your weekends were awesome. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you, custom meme of the day by Moen Zimani. Title of the thread was, Grandpa, look! Look, it's the guy! It's the YouTuber dude! It's the one who fails 73% all the time! Oh! That's me. Hi, Grandpa. Hopefully you're recovered from Thanksgiving now. That's right. Thank you very much, Moen Zimani, and all 304 of you who upvoted that one. Lots of upvotes. Today is going to be Romeo Foxtrot Zulu Zulu 6 Delta Romeo Hotel. We've got good damage, decent tiers, above average tiers, I would say. Wait, what? Along with the quarter and the golden torn pocket, which I'm just going to go ahead and yeet right now. Obviously, we only have one HP, so we got to be real careful with our HP, especially if we're going up against champions, because that would be a horrible way to end things here. The sprinkler, you know, the sprinkler is not bad, but it's definitely no wait what. Wait what gives us that butterbean pushback effect, and also, of course, gives us that awesome fissure effect, which did not go off because I walked up to this headless Isaac torso thinking that it would. So, yeah, good way. It's a Monday, you know. I have not played today any Isaac at all. I've been out of the house basically all day working on some new music with Mark. And on top of that, we also have... I thought that was going to hit it. On top of that, we also had football, of course, so lots of people just hanging out, having a good time, playing games, watching games, and all that kind of good stuff. Definitely want to wait till we go and have our Butterbean, or wait, what I should say, ready to go for the next rooms, because obviously we need to be very cautious here, especially on one half heart, although we just got remedied that. But yeah, wait, what is a very reliable source of damage, as well as defensive power in early runs. You can use it against bosses, and it's very effective at taking out the lower end of the boss train, but obviously you still have to be careful, especially with charging bosses like Dingle, for example. So we definitely want to have this unicorn poop available to us and not pop it until we absolutely need to. These poops actually in the corner, these four corners here, are going to be extremely, extremely important for us, because we need to use them for basically barricades whenever Dingle does charge. So as long as Dingle doesn't make it behind one of these, we should be completely safe, and we don't want them to be destroyed, unless if we know for sure that we're about to kill Dingle, kind of like right now, although we're not too sure. But I mean, we're still pretty safe right here. There we go. We're fine with letting that rip. Get a half red heart anyway. We're hoping for a little bit of HP. Honestly, something like Squeezy would be awesome. Meat would be awesome. You know, anything that gives us damage. Really anything that just isn't like basic HP. Movement speed, not really what we wanted, obviously. Movement speed still going to be useful, but not anywhere near as useful as like HP would have been. Super Secret Room, I think, is right here, but we have... Until I can get the spacing right on when we drop we're not going to be able to open it. I know the secret room's to the left of this room. I know that for a fact. There we go. We'll check the secret room real fast, and yep. About what we would expect. And there's a soul heart here, along with the High Priestess, which we can use on the next floor. Wooden nickel. We do need a Yave. I'm not gonna buy one from the store though, because we really want to get we really want to get value out of this out of us starting with the quarter, and that's gonna require us getting like one passive item, because technically speaking, we didn't start with a passive item. We just started with a quarter, and that's not what we want. What we really, really want, I guess it's possible it's not there. I'd be surprised that if it's not. What we really want is a passive item like Champion Belt, something like that. Can't be there. I don't know. I don't care, dude. I'm over it. But going back to it, we have to get value for our space for our starting passive item if we start with something like the quarter. And the reason why I say that is because, again, technically speaking, we have nothing to show for our starting item currently. It's just the quarter. It does nothing for us passively. It just gives us money. So that money is useless to us unless we have something like money equals power, which of course we don't, or we have an item from the store that we bought with said quarter that's representative of a starting item. Because again, on its own, the quarter means absolutely nothing. Wow, a double super jump from across all of those rocks. That is something. That's some schmoovin' right there, I tell you what. Trying to get them to jump into the fire. I don't think I've ever seen this room before, but I'm already hating it. There we go. We stopped them right before they could get that attack off. And there is no force on God's green earth to make me go through this gauntlet here, not with this damage or tears rate. So we're just going to do that. And we get shot anyway, because of course we do. They shot literally before the rocks could be destroyed. That is some next level programming, Ed. So down goes the soul heart. I mean, it's not a huge deal if we don't get this devil deal, because we don't have enough HP anyway to really make it happen. I'm very thankful that we have the High Priestess card, because we can use that against the boss. But again, we're gonna have to skip out on the Devil Deal in lieu of going for Angel Deals, just for safety at this point. Get the Swallowed Penny, and yep, that is an item that we cannot get. All right. That instinctively, just in case there's a bunch of spiders that came out of there. We still need a key to get inside of the store. And you can just walk out and walk back in, and that will respawn the spiders. We don't owe the game anything here. We don't owe the game the pleasure of us not having our spacebar item ready to go by walking into a room unprepared. You know, because that's just giving the game the advantage, and we don't want to do that right now, especially on 1 HP. You get ourselves the Yave, so I'm going to backtrack to go to the Tienda and hopefully get us one of these soul heartos. Treasure map is going to be good here. I wouldn't mind getting the... the other one. I've already forgotten what was over there. Wow. Cricket Smelter is what I was thinking of. You know, that one felt good. Now, PJ's gives us enough HP to make the Devil Deal actually matter, so I am going to go in there, and it doesn't matter anyway, because we have a blank Devil Deal. Very happy that the latest patch reduced this the frequency of this happening. Very, very good for us here.
Happy Monday, everybody!
If you don't know what I'm talking about, the latest patch supposedly has been made to stop that from happening. So stop these blank devil deals from happening. But alas, here we are. Glass Eye, again, very, very common showing up here, and I am just all for it. Again, it's just more damage for us. And, you know, gimme, gimme, gimme. Okay, I'm glad that went off at way, way, way after when I was trying to cast it. We are all kinds of just discombobulated right now. It's a very, very long day today, that's for sure. Thankfully, the Buccaneers won, even though they tried their best to not win. It's the lowly Indianapolis Colts. Could have made a couple of friendly bets on that game. Chose not to. I'm going to go in the curse room because we need something right now. Yep, you know it's gonna be one of those. It's got to be a Monday. We're getting hit by death rattles and just random bad gases everywhere and blank devil deals. It's a rip roaring good time here today. Definitely a Monday. Not gonna go in the skinny room. Stono item room. There we go. This room is an exercise in patience and control of your damage. And which is why this is an excellent room for newer Isaac players to practice. Practicing the concept of not firing every single opportunity you get a chance to is very important. It teaches you a couple things. First off, it teaches you self-control. And secondly, it teaches you how to control your damage in the game. Both of those things are very important in Isaac. Yeah. Gives us plus 2 health up. I don't know if that's... I'm not sure if that health is... Can we use that health for devil deals, I wonder? I was about to use wait what there, and then I realized that we're next to a mushroom, and we all saw what happened last time I did that. Perfect use there of wait what to get us not only the super secret room, but take down a couple of the globins. We got the swarm going, we get a useless super secret room. And we get a fun old boss like Bambino. The fun boss. Apparently, Bambino can just go through that, the fissure of, wait, what? Still dealing decent damage to him, though. It's Sty, which is another new item, damage and range up, only from our left eye, and we get this devil deal here. I mean, at least we can be happy that we got a devil deal, but I don't think that it's going to matter all that much. I will farm a little bit of money from this Demon Judgment, though. I'm still not going to take this Devil Deal. I will take Empty Vessel, which is going to give us flying. We can go get that... Yes, we can go get that Golden Chest now. So you just saw our temporary HP has gone. I wonder if that works with, like, Guppy's Paw. By it, I mean the temporary HP from the Empress card. Surely it does, right? I'd assume it does. A very odd spot for the secret room. I have a feeling it's going to be below the item room now. The only place I can conceivably see it. And it is. Okay. All right. Might as well go get a little bit of extra money here. We definitely want to maintain... Oh, wow. We want to maintain the empty vessel bonus for as long as possible, mainly because of flying, but also the damage shield is quite nice. Definitely loving the treasure map. It gives us at least a little bit of semblance to where we're supposed to be going. Some kind of direction, anyway. You see the Sty shot. It looks very reminiscent of Sacred Heart. And it does hit very hard. I mean, you know, it's nothing. It's definitely a damage up for sure. Your DPS undoubtedly goes up whenever you take Stye. I don't know how that dip got all the way from here to down here. We get the empty vessel proc, which doesn't really mean a whole lot because it's just going to go away as soon as we get in here. I had no idea the secret room was there, but now we do. Okay. So at least we can get out of the secret room here for free of charge. Double proc there on the... Ooh, triple proc. And look at us getting all fancy. Triple proc on the counterfeit penny. Counterfeit penny is going to increase the amount of money that we pick up by one per coin. Sometimes. It's not a guarantee, but it usually procs at a very decent rate. Are you seeing the speed at which these things are schmoving? Again, we don't want any red hearts right now. That is going to affect our devil deal, but we haven't really gotten any devil deals yet. So technically speaking, we could theoretically still get an angel deal, which I wouldn't mind at this point because devil deals for the past like day or two have not been spectacular. I've been very generoso. I'm not going to wait for it to recharge. Lucky Rock into Counterfeit Penny gives us a lot of extra money. Probably should have just waited to pick those up before picking them up because we had the Counterfeit Penny, but I can't be asked. Teleport 2.0. I mean, here's the thing with... the fact that we have, wait, what? That means that we basically guarantee that we're able to get into the secret room on this floor anyway. Just gonna clear these out here. Again, it's inconsequential for us to use Teleport 2.0 right now just because we have enough floors to make that back. The real turd in the punch bowl is going to be getting into the boss trap room. I don't know if Teleport 2.0 is good. Like, here's the thing with Teleport 2.0 is the change to the boss trap room really screws Teleport 2.0 because, again, you have to sacrifice so much just to get into a room that usually doesn't have all that great reward, and the barrier of entry is very high. I mean, you've got to be willing to, unless you're playing as a loss, you got to be willing to sacrifice basically every part of your being, of your life here. We really should go back and pick up the counterfeit penny if we're not going to carry Wait What. Honestly, I'm thinking about just going back and taking Wait What again. We need to get full charges. At least Wait What gives us some defensive measures. And also, to be honest, like, IM air rooms just aren't that great either. Like, I'm just going to say it. They haven't been good for a while. Rolling Hourglass would also not be horrible. End up getting that needle anyway. Wasn't trying to kill that needle. By God. Figure why not. We could try for a soul heart. We're going... If we use the... Assuming that we don't get a devil deal, which we probably won't, or an angel deal, we will be taken to the, I believe, the dice room first and then the boss trap room. But we don't have enough full charges to make it happen. And that's kind of what I was just alluding to about the change to the boss trap room really, really hurts the value of Teleport 2.0. I mistimed that by 1 second, unfortunately. Get another range upgrade, which does give us a speed up or a... Yeah, speed upgrade as well. We did get our angel deal, which is good. But we're one away from getting out of that. We can reroll. I'm just gonna get rid of teleport 2.0. I don't like it here. I don't think it's that great anymore. Gonna pick it up. We can use the four room to reroll all item pedestals on the level, which is basically just the item room, and we get Proptosis. Proptosis, I will take. The only reason why I'm going to take it here is because it does give a. I mean, we're going to be able to perform some close combat with enemies. I know I could have used Wait What, but I thought that was going to be the counterfeit penny. Counterfeit penny's over here. We can get the bombs back. Wait, no, it's not. Where's the... We leave it in the vault? Oh, whatever. Has... No, Birthright... The hourglass turned to Birthright. Interesting. So Birthright with Eden's going to give us three random items. And we get Rock Bottom. Well, then. It appears we have a little bit of a run going. Get Rock Freaking Bottom. Bloody Penny is not horrible either. Surprised that we kept our little Clotty. No, never mind, he's dead. Wow, I cannot believe that Bony lived through that. We hit that Dark Bony right on the nose with the fissure. Okay. All right, game. Purgatory is going to give us those red fissures here. We get Steam Sail. I swear the game's just pulling out all kinds of random damage now. I don't even think the game knows where some of this damage is coming from. Yep. You know what? You can have that money. So Rock Bottom is going to prevent us from losing stats, or at least it creates kind of a floor that stats can no longer cross. So basically anything that has any sort of downside, like soy milk, for example, anything that lowers our stats at all, like experimental treatment, is rendered useless basically. Purgatory, we're going to step on those red fissures and it's going to give us an exploding spirit and just flies out. And Purgatory has been showing up a whole lot lately, and I'm okay with it because, man, it does a number on enemy projectiles. And given the frequency that we've been getting hit by death rattles in this run so far, it's going to be a welcome addition to our defense. This is a pretty awful shop again. But at least we can say that we got Rock Bottom out of a store. Thanks to Birthright, anyway. Yeah, so our single target damage, as long as things are close up to us, is very respectable here at Proptosis. But the further that things move away, the worse it gets. There you go. Perfect timing on that Pogatory. Another one coming in. We're just sending the Pogs. There we go. We hit Speedball, and that's going to give us our second syringe item. And we are now moving. We got some range upgrades as well. We've already missed Boss Rush, so I'm not going to worry about backtracking here. I want to go back in our... I want to go to our curse room and hopefully get us a damage upgrade. I mean, a tiers upgrade would be great. I would not kick a tiers upgrade out of bed for eating crackers, if you know what I mean. Fantastic. All right. And we will just head on down to the next exciting floor. Binding of Isaac Repentance. All right, so the boss is undoubtedly going to be to the bottom left. I think we need to stop trying to use Wait What as our offense now, especially with Proptosis being here. That's been the majority of the reason why we've been getting hit lately. Oh, good. And just looking for black hearts here. I think this could be our item room. I don't think it is, but it definitely could be. It's definitely not the boss, I can tell you that, 100%. It's our item room. Let me chub. Give her a little taste of something spicy. It's weird that she pulled off of the charge like that, as if there was like still like, as if there was still skulls there that she couldn't pass. It's very weird. Depression, not very good. Occasionally depression will throw down a holy beam of light. Also known as Crack the Skizzle. We only have two keys left. I'm going to take the risk and go into the vault anyway. And just something that requires more keys, because of course it does. All right. Here, just... It's different shades of... Many shades of gray here. I don't mean in the fun kind either. Wow. Also, apparently the fissure just doesn't do a whole lot of damage. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me, of course, but I don't know if they actually changed the damage coefficient of the fissure, but it seems to be reduced by a whole lot. We're just taking the first train to Bad Damageville, Population 1. Cool card here. Definitely would not mind getting a piercing shot or two or 10. Swarm is trying to help us mitigate it, but obviously without the flying aspect and the shield aspect of having empty vessel, our defensive capabilities are not super great. Our final shop was a greed fight, of course. Surprising lack of tinted rocks, with us having so many bombs and a free way, other than costing us time, to produce possible soul hearts here. Assuming that we actually get a tinted rock, which we have not, I don't believe, seen one yet. We really need Pogatory, but... Oh, there's spike rocks there. Okay, yep. A charge key and a golden bomb. Isaac. Great job by Purgatory stopping that horse shot. Really hoping that we get some use out of rock bottom. And that's another 73%. Grandpa! Grandpa, yo! Get in here! Grandpa, he did it! He did it again! It's that YouTuber! The one in the meme, it's the exact same floor, yo! Let's go! I don't even know how these things start, man. Don't try to ask me how my brain works sometimes. I've given up on trying to figure it out. Definitely thought the secret room was going to be there. Purgatory is going to be excellent in this room. As you see, it just cancels out all the death rattle effects of enemies, and that can be very, very popular and very strong and powerful. Again, given the frequency that we are currently afflicted by death rattle shots and stuff, having something that just totally cancels that out is muy bueno. But as with Death's List, you should never try to force the issue with Purgatory. Don't try to take a fissure if like it could possibly get you hit. Purgatory definitely doing some work here. This definitely feels like a new room as well. Wow, yeah, they must have changed the fissure damage. That is surprisingly bad. I kind of committed here on these red chests, and man, am I glad we did. Let me bloat. HP upgrade and an angel deal. It gives us the holy mantle. And we might as well get the boosted angel deal chance here. And we're just going to keep feeding Purgatory the Uriel. And head on down. No real finesse here, just trying to get through Utero. We're going negative because we needed damage, and because with rock bottom, we can definitely start balling out of control with the big asterisk of hopefully we can get something that, like, you know, works. Like kidney stone, soy milk, almond milk, even at this point, I would take anything really that gives us some kind of edge right now. Because tears rate is where we're getting stung real bad. Our damage is on point thanks to mostly Proptosis. And I don't, again, I don't know for sure if they changed the damage from the fissure of wait what, but it just feels like it did. Feels like it pushes them more than it used to, and it also deals less damage. It just straight up just deals less damage. I mean, I don't remember seeing things just kind of fly off and bounce off and just shrug it off on the old wait what. Holy Mantle, by the way, is going to give us the Holy Mantle effect. Surprise, surprise. Which is, of course, giving us a free hit every single time we go into a new room or if we zone into and out of a room. So it's very effective at stopping bad damage. But again, without us having the Polar Invincibility and also without us having the possibility of Empty Vessel, you know, we still need to be very cautious here. I don't always recommend destroying the red face skulls here, but if you can isolate one of them and take him out, definitely do so. You'll be happier for it, especially in a really cramped room like this. Especially since they just explode anyway once you kill all the active other targets in the room besides them. Okay, Purgatory. You just step it up, son. That was pretty poor. I use a hot bomb here. My bomb's usually pretty good against mom. And we don't get to deal with the devil or deal with the angel. And yeah. Sure hope we get some use out of rock bottom. Look at the size of that Isaac circle. Maybe I'm phrasing it wrong. Man, it sure would be fun to get some use out of rock bottom. Make sure the game can hear me clearly in that. Chain Purgatory, look at that. Finally get some soul hearts here from our Tinted Rock. Very rarely seen Tinted Rock. Purgatory really scoring off the charts here in terms of being able to clear stuff that we can't see. That's why it's so good. Yep, and this would have been an Isaac Circle, although there is a possibility that could be Satan in the middle here, so we're going to have to just do a full clear anyway. A luck penny, which I'm fine with. You know what? Let's walk out and try that again. Been going to curse rooms for free because of Holy Mantle. Can confirm that was not Stanley. So now we know. We did find our regular secret room over here. Again, these are inaccessible items. Game, we cannot fully take use of this. We would have to lose our Red Heart HP in order to get Red Heart HP here. The reason why I say that is because obviously we have flying with Empty Vessel. Might as well check this room here. I didn't think it was going to be there, but you never know. I refuse to take part in this room. Yeah, Purgatory, very effective at taking down armored enemies as well. You just saw it cancel out all the shots from Super Greed there. And we're starting to get caught up in keys. I'm gonna try to keep up with Purgatory as much as we can. It's additive damage. It's supplemental damage, I guess is the best way to say it. It's damage that we don't have to put that much effort into, and as long as we're staying safe and not going for some risky fissures in the ground, you know, Purgatory is just going to be nothing but value. Here goes Stanley. Here goes that crazy Stanley. Damage with hot bombs there. The idea of burning Satan is hilarious to me. Yeah, it's not that funny, but it's kind of funny. Yeah, you'd think a guy that hangs out in fire all day wouldn't be able to be burned by hot bombs, but here we are. Yeah, we're just kind of moving around here. Not with any real rhyme or reason for us picking Purgatory, but it's working. Curse of Darkness. All right, let's see. Eye of Belial is very good for Babylon, and Judas is freaking Shadow. I think we take all of these. We'll take Horror Babylon. So we don't really need Lord of the Pit. Especially with us having, having empty Vesta. Why does it look like we have the Book of Virtues? What is that? Something about tainted dark juice I don't know about. I mean, technically we're not. I mean, no, we're not tainted. What am I talking about? We're playing as regular Eden. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with that. Anybody got time for that? We do have a full card here that we've kept since Depths 2, just in case if we end up running into problems life-wise. We still have a way to reset the Holy Mantida. But now I'm really curious to see what happens when we're Dark Judas and Rock Bottom. And I wasn't planning on doing a victory lap here, but we definitely, now I'm kind of really pumped for it, because this is going to be a massive amount of damage, especially with Eye of Belial here. Potentially pretty incredible. They got Lust first and go straight for Pride. And we'll just let Purgatory take care of Envy. All right, well, remember we have a full card, so if we end up getting in trouble, we can use the Holy Mantle to reset the Holy Mantle. The Purgatory is going to make things a lot easier for us. I was pushed. Apparently we had the shield from Empty Vessel, which I was not privy to. The job on Purgatory. Again, this is a textbook example of how good Purgatory is at canceling projectiles. And yeah, you know what? Let's do it. I wasn't planning on it, but hey, that run, it was somewhat satisfying. Other than the bad damage, I know we can do better. So let's do better. I can run 3-3 Foxtrot Zulu 769 Charlie. We need to get some H Pizzle. There we go. Again, we get in and out of curse rooms for free. And this damage that we have will never go down. We really, really, really need, other than HP, we need some tears rate. Our tears rate is by far what is the thing that's most holding us back here. So if we can just do us, if we can just get a solid, the game just do us a solid, I'd love to get a tears rate upgrade. It's not a tears rate upgrade. Also got Pyromaniac, which is going to give us explosion immunity as well as heal us. So not only will we not take damage from explosions, including like mom stomps, like the foot stomp or daddy long leg stomps, we are also going to be healed from that. So yeah, it's pretty good. Hangman card. It's going to be a little bit redundant, I would say. Slightly redundant. Not really paying attention to secret rooms anymore right now. That is some monster damage there with Proptosis, Rock Bottom, and Eye of Belial. That is scary. In a good way. Sure. We'll take 9.5 Volt. We will also take that. And a Floor 1 Fallen. Oh my gosh. Okay, well that is some big time damage right there. Big time damage. Yep. Wouldn't mind getting some mapping in terms of like if we could get like something to the effect of the compass, that would be cool. The mine would also not be something I'd be too upset about. Apparently 4.5 Volt does not work for Butterbean or for Wait What? That's news to me. Can someone please inform NL of this new discovery? He will not believe me. Just tell him to believe me anyway. Say source dude, trust me. Source, we saw Sinvicta do it. And he'd be like, hey everybody. Followed by some sarcastic quip about Seinfeld. I believe I was just tearing everything a new one right now. And we get BF Izzle, which is going to give us more damage from depression and from Lil Abba Dabba Ding Dong. I believe now makes it on par with standard base levels Abaddon. Could be wrong about that. Probably am. But it does look a lot better. It does look a lot closer to regular Maw of the Void. I didn't mean regular Abaddon. I meant regular Maw of the Void. Take marbles, and marbles gave us basically nothing we care about. We get salvation. A little Abaddon plus BFF with that full-size Maw of the Void is real nice. Gotta say. No complaints here. Just go check up here real quick because there may have been an item room. Not usually, but it's possible. And again, you see how effective we are at dispatching enemies very quickly here with the combined damage of Proptosis plus the increased damage that we get from Eye of Belial, giving us a piercing shot. Whenever it pierces through a target, it becomes piercing, and it will also turn into homing, and then those tiers will deal increased amount of damage to the targets. And oh, don't look now, but we've got Cricket's body. We finally get a tiers up, although this is not what I would say is my ideal tiers up, because Cricket's body is very distracting and also kind of overbearing in terms of visuals. It can throw you off. It can definitely make you see ghosts out there. Those of you who ever play quarterback know what I'm talking about. You will definitely feel the ghosts. It's sharp key. More like sharp no thank you, please. All right. We're going to fill up with all sorts of goodies here. Yeah, you know what? I'll take Keeper's Box. You never know what we might be able to. Never know what we might be able to play with. I don't know what that sound was when Dark Judas was using Keeper's Box. Sun card gives us full mapping for one floor anyway. So say thank you to Wait What. You've been an amazing host for this run. I did get in some trouble by trying to use you after telling people to not do that. Look how fast, and we get another tiers up in shot speed. That is huge for us. So we're going to check down here real fast. I mean, we basically one-shot everything now. There's no real mystery to who's going to end up winning this one. Ace of Spades is going to give us keys everywhere. And all those soul hearts will definitely seal the deal. Ace of Spades is going to turn all enemies in the room and everything on the ground into keys. But for some reason, we ever run out of our keys, we have a very easy way to make a whole lot more. Ares is going to give us movement speed, but we've already maxed out on movement speed. We'll still have the ability to get the invincibility going, which, again, I have not really been paying attention to how exactly that works. I don't think we need to worry about it here. Basically, the faster that you travel, the longer or the better that the invincibility shield is going to last. I'm going to save our Ace. I know that like people were expecting me to use it in here, but I'm actually going to save our Ace of Spades for the next XO room. Swarm doing an excellent job at keeping us safe. Well, we got less keys for it, but that's okay. And again, this when you've got this much damage, you're just going to roll over everything. Yeah, that is just... Get another HP upgrade, and we get Revelation, which, boy, this is going to be a nasty amount of damage. Yep. Yeah, that's going to do it. Revelation plus Rock Bottom and Dark Judas. Oh, boy. Dreamcatcher showing that we have Blue Babies, or My Best Friend, I should say, in the item room, so we know we don't need to go in there. Empress card does not give us a buff. I think it's because we already have, we've already got Horde Babylon. We've not been hit since we've not taken damage, let's put it that way. We've been hit a couple times, but we've not taken damage since actually picking up and acquiring the Holy Mantida. I had to see for myself. Yeah, we'll take a Razor. I think that we should take this opportunity as well to put items or put money back in the donation machine. Never mind, it's a victory lap. Don't listen to me. Or Babylon again. It's not going to do anything for us. We're already pretty much maxed. The Eraser will allow us to get rid of something. I don't really mind dingles. We're looking for needles, obviously. Needles are bonies. Wouldn't mind getting rid of leapers, but again, with the swarm here, we're pretty much protected. And Pogatory, of course. We want to erase something. Fight the boss real quick. It's going to be war. That goes war. Yeah, if we end up buying the Eraser, we definitely want to get some value out of it. So let's backtrack a little bit, even though it's pretty much a moot point at this point. Why not make it easier on yourself, you know? Why be against yourself when everything else is? You need to be your own number one fan. Especially in Isaac. Not just a self-esteem thing, it's everything. You need to be your number one. If you're not going to be on your team and root for yourself, then who is? You know? You got to think about Team A over here. Can we get leapers? We should get Globins or Bonies in here. Knights aren't really a problem. We have piercing shots. I do hate the Mr. Mines, but we can deal with them. Again, with Revelation, we can deal with pretty much anything and everything. Now, we also could be using and should be using these pills, because they can't really affect us. Unless it's a bad trip, health down, or retrovision, or something like that. There we go. Needles have been removed from the game. Ah, sorry, Needles fans out there. The little bygods have been bygone. I mean, Leech wouldn't really care about Leech, especially as Black Judas, because we don't have any red hearts, so a real reason for us to keep it. Look at all the needles that were just removed from this room. The game's like, oh, okay. Again, more needles gone. Love to see that little pink like puff of smoke indicating that something was erased. Ourselves a nice little Yave here. Probably should have removed the Globins. Dips, I also wouldn't mind getting rid of. But again, the amount of damage that we're able to do, plus our defensive upgrades, just makes this impossible for the game. Wouldn't mind getting rid of you all. You lot. We're running out of stuff to remove now. We got to erase something. We're going to have to do it in Boss Rush, I suppose. Backtracks because it was missing poster. We could go in the curse room. We got plenty of time, and we also might find spiders or something in there that we want to erase. You just want to get value out of the eraser. That's basically what it comes down to. Everything in Isaac has an inherent and non-inherent value. In this case, the value is it is speculative because you don't know how much of an impact removing an enemy from the enemy table, loot table, is going to be. Our fool card in there was so we can get out of the boss rush. Well, you know that I'm racing mini strobes. You know your boy was cocked, locked, and ready to rock for that. Yeah, we could do boss rush if we wanted to, but there's no reason to. We could even go fight old Beastie if we wanted to. Gonna stick with perfection. Rock bottom perfection, I believe, still means that we never ever lose luck ever. We really don't have to worry about the stomping damage here from Mom because of Pyromaniac. Oh, it's just his breath of life again. Oh boy. Boss rush. I mean, I said I'd do it. So this is going to be interesting now. Almond Milk makes this run pretty wacky. Let's get even wackier by go say hi to old Beastie. Old Beastie. Yep, I am fine with removing bonies. 100%. Yeah, Almond Milk again with rock bottom just makes us to where we just don't. There's not a care in the world at this point. Other than the fact that we literally went in the wrong direction. We know the other one's a glowing hourglass. Give me a little bit of rerolling here, yeah. Death card gives us a bone shield, a la Book of the Dead. Moving box. Alabaster box. Wouldn't be horrible. I don't know where the secret room is currently. I think we know that it's not connected to that room or this room. Maybe here? It is there. Get raw liver, which doesn't do anything for us. Why not? Really shouldn't have done that. I wasn't even thinking about the fact that we could have rerolled. I mean, we had more options, or not more options. We had Black Candle there. Hopefully Mama Mega. Oops. I would like to try to, if we could somehow fill Alabaster Box, that would be great. Mama Mega could potentially do it for us with all the soul hearts and everything around. Okay. So our goal here is to try to get, hopefully, an angel deal item from Alabaster Box. We're only going to get one because obviously we've already taken a devil deal. The game doesn't appreciate that. We're going to do a full clear here thanks to Mama Mega. And the Soul Heart here. Just need two more. You get an Emperor card, which doesn't really matter at this point. Two Emperor cards. That. They are. Satanic Bible is definitely not what we wanted. I got the curse room real fast. Yeah. I say we go back. We get the eraser just for the fun. We're gonna have to go all the way back here. But what a Monday run it's been. You know, we had early stages of bad damage and just, you know, overall sloppiness, but we managed to persevere through it. And you know, now we're looking very, very solid. Very strong run. Proptosis, rock bottom, almond milk. What's not there to love about this? Revelation? Revelation is going to absolutely smoke Beast. Like, it's not even going to be close.
Benton, it's gone. Just get over it.
You mean it's gone? How could you have spent our savings?
I missed. There we go. Just taking out some of the trash.
He's self-destructive and disturbs just like his father.
Wish he could take down the spikes.
You're drunk again, aren't you?
Shut up, man.
There we
Shut
go.
Up. Just keep pushing me like this.
Not to worry about no. Oh, well, those dark bonies and globins in there. That's what I would have definitely re-rolled, or not re-rolled, but removed from the entire game. And it goes for the big grubs. You ain't Big Chub. There's only one Big Chub. And you ain't it. Big Chub is immaculate. Fine, I'll open it. Are you happy? Guppy's paw. I believe that's our first Guppy item. Not that it really matters, of course. Old Beastie is not going to be old happy. Removed the big mega swarm flies, and I'm okay with that. Yeah, we don't have to worry about explosions because we have Pyromaniac. Sure, why not? Cracky. Go. Oh my gosh. So even though we didn't really get like a whole lot of we didn't get a whole lot of what I would say incredible items here with rock bottom, we could have done better for sure. But the run turned out to be an absolute slaughter. There we go. No more champion Diglets either. We have another full charge, so... Okay, well, I missed anyway. We had another full charge thanks to the battery. Also, weren't you supposed to be erased, Megafly? And away we go. Second to last run of November. Can you believe it's already close to December? I mean, we're that close, man. December's right around the corner in just 2 days. And then this year's over. And then straight up, 2021's over. Bring on 2022. What a year it's been. We had undoubtedly the biggest release of my YouTube career in Repentance. A fine game that you're seeing right here. And definitely a lot of people's introduction to Isaac. Try to erase Dogma here, that'd be fun. Okay, well, we didn't do enough damage to him. I don't even care if you hit us, dude. Our damage is overwhelming. That is just making salvation even better. Let's go ahead and smack Beast in the face and just wrap up today's very fun Monday run. And let me know how you did on this run. Again, I love reading those comments. Those of you who actually play along at home, been getting a lot of people saying that actually that their kids are playing along with them, and that is awesome. Kids, if you're watching this on YouTube with your parents' permission, who's better? Who's the better player? You or your mom? Or you or your dad? Or is it a competition? Is it you versus your mom versus your dad? Who's the best in the household? I'd love to know. These are the trivia questions about the mosh pit that keep me up at night. Salvation is going absolutely ballistic here. And it's not even at full strength either. That's the crazy thing. At war already in phase two. Yeah, you cannot stop this. Death didn't even make it to the second animation. Leech is just rocking out in the lava. And that is going to be it for old Beastie. So thank you for watching, everybody. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click that like button. If you didn't, well, there's no dislike button anymore, but you could let me know in the comments down below. It's also a great way to support my channel. On top of doing everything else, go check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta. All the links can be found, including to the Sinvicta subreddit, down below in the information box. Those of you on mobile devices, you can simply click on the description, and that will give you the right location that you need to be. And thank you all very much for making the like streak possible. If this video or yesterday's video crosses 5,000 likes, we will definitely be there. So again, thank you all very much for making November awesome. Let's end the year in the mosh pit with a bang. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Nicholas Knight, Nate Meldick, Lasidius Dex Ludix, Warren Hosinian, and Kelly McGuire. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.